think I got mixed personalities. This is up my home and
Bim.
Yeah.
What would you do if I asked you to make it official? What would you say on them?
Are you doing this also now? Guys, don't watch my forehead, yeah? Hey guys, your boy is Tranzking, King, and I'm with...
It's your girl, Charnation, and you're
and watching Ournationzzz.
That's the first time we did that correctly.
Today we're doing... We're cooking lasagna.
Yeah, I'm doing a lasagna plus sides mukbang on my channel, and yeah, we're basically cooking it today because we did it on Snap. I made it one time and like posted it on Snap and everyone was like, oh my god, how do you make that? I want the recipe. So yeah, basically we're just showing you how I make it, and yeah, then we're gonna eat it over on my channel. But yeah, hope you enjoy the video, guys.
Cool. Okay, I keep thinking to shout here, but I need to shout over there. Okay, basically, everything you're gonna need for the lasagna is lasagna sheets, mince.
You said lasagna sheets for a little bit.
Yeah, go into a second. The two lasagna sauces, obviously the red one and the white one. You can make it yourself if you want to, you actually couldn't boil. Oil, any seasoning you wanna put in it, all I've got is all purpose. Cheese, obviously. A frying pan and a baking tray that's like, you know, deep enough for the size of the lasagna you want to make, basically. But yeah, first thing I'm gonna do is start soaking some of my lasagna sheets. I do that basically so it's like half cooked already, so like the sheets don't come out crispy or hard when you eat it.
You didn't do that.
Yeah, obviously I'm gonna do that, and then I'm gonna fry the mince, and yeah, you're gonna see what we're gonna do. But yeah,
well, we're gonna put it into soak
the tray.
Using this one first.
Hmm?
Using this one first?
Yeah.
Let me freeze it for right now.
No, you can put some on top of each other, just to keep it moving. I'm only gonna do some. No, not yet, like when the water's in.
So right now we're just putting the oil in the frying pan, and we're gonna fry the mince.
Very lovely.
So guys, I've got extra stuff that I want to do because it's a mukbang that I don't eat. Like, usually we just eat lasagna on its own. But obviously I've got sweet corn, coleslaw, got like these garlic bread, dough, ball thingies, and cucumber. But obviously we can start doing that once it's in the oven. So, yeah.
That's only going to take like 10 minutes.
Yeah, it's not. So yeah, you just pour the hot water into whatever you're using to soak the the pasta sheets. And then yeah, you just leave them for like 10 minutes until they're like, they're not gonna cook because you're gonna be here for hours waiting, like just for like 10 minutes so they can get soft-ish, and then put them on a plate, let them wait. They might stick a little bit to each other, but it's okay because you can break it apart when you're putting the lasagna together, so it's not that deep. But yeah, basically you just gotta like try not to let it stick too much, but even if it does, it don't matter. As long as it's not like completely wedged, snuck onto each other, then it's annoying to like, because they'll break off probably. But yeah, if they're like a little bit stuck, then it's fine. The only ones that really need to be soaked are the ones that are going at the top, because the bottom one will get cooked with the mince, the middle one will get cooked with the mince, and then depending on how many layers of mince you do, they'll be fine. But the top one that you put on, that only has a sauce on top, it usually stays a bit hard if you don't cook it for ages. So they're the ones that may need to be soaked. Obviously at this point you can put onion if you want to. We haven't got none, but usually I don't even like to put onion in the lasagna because
it's not crispy.
I don't know. That's how it's supposed to be though.
How many put on top?
I don't know.
No, I'll just put a few.
Yeah, that's gonna be enough for the top, to be honest, and the rest can just go in hot. You can leave it, you don't even have to flip it.
Huh? Slowly getting softer.
Yeah.
This one is the pill. I'm not putting it, I'm moving it. So you sit together, aren't you?
Yeah, I know. You can start to add whatever seasonings you like. Whenever you want, really.
If you even season the food.
Hmm?
So if they even season the food.
Yeah, I mean, to be honest with lasagna, I don't even season it that much. Because I feel like you want it to taste like lasagna. So obviously, lasagna is like, it tastes a certain way. It's like tomato-y, garlicky. It's not like, it doesn't taste like all purpose. It tastes like lasagna. I can't explain, but yeah. You can put whatever you want in
there.
Tastes like the sauce. Yeah, I'm mainly just like, as long as the sauce is good and the cheese is good.
Hmm? Okay, maybe.
On a plate after, just leave them in there for a couple minutes.
This one nearly, the first one.
Yeah, as long as they get a little bit like that, like they have a little bit of a flop and it's not hard and like straight anymore. Then you know that it's been soaked enough. Like that's all it needs to do, like it just needs to flop a little bit. Like you don't want to cook it in the boiling water because then it'll get too soggy when you actually cook it in the oven. But yeah, basically just let it flop a little bit, let it flop a little bit, let it flop a little bit. But if you're really lazy like me and you can't bother to soak every single sheet you're going to do, just make sure the top ones, like the top layer before you put the white sauce, that it has the soaked ones.
Cool. Like the last time when you saw it,
you didn't bother
with it at all.
Yeah, like the last time, like if you saw it on my snap, I didn't soak them, but the top layer was a little bit hard in the middle.
So guys, basically during this time of editing, me and Ray are both editing, yeah, and we both needed to go to the toilet. So first of all, he like decides to jump on me whilst we're on the bed, and I get up and he's still like hanging on me. And then he gets up and I start like slowly running to the door, like to go to the bathroom, but he tries to get in front of me. So I barge him because I'm like, no, I need to go to the toilet. But then obviously he's on my right, yeah. We're running, and then like I barge him, and he slips. I feel like it went in slow motion because like he slipped, like you know when you proper like slip your foot up and you drop back, and he was gonna his head was gonna hit the ground, but instead of barging him anymore.
Wait, how into the ground? It was gonna hit into the cupboard.
No, you was going backwards. Yeah, you was going backwards. So no, you was going forwards. So I decided to make you go backwards, basically, because you was gonna headbutt the wooden thing, but instead
the cupboard.
Yeah, but I said instead of that, push up to the floor because that's you know safer. So I pushed him down instead of pushing him up. So yeah, I saved him.
The door where it has been layered on top, and obviously the only thing on top was the sauce, whereas the other layers have sauce, mince, and like obviously that's all hot and it melts into it and
string here and cheese
and everything else, whereas the top it's only got a little bit of sauce and cheese, so it's not really gonna cook like that. So yeah, this is cooked basically. Like now this is when I'll put on the oven. I cook it at like 200 or like 8 if you have like a gas cooker, but I'll put it on like 150 to heat it up, or like a 6 if you have gas.
It's
how
fluffy it's meant to be.
Like that basically.
Obviously it's going to get harder again if you leave it out too long.
Quite like not that much oil, just
like
a little bit, just so it don't like get stuck up.
I don't get stuck up. So you mean stuck up?
Or stuck?
Pour this water out.
Yeah.
Can I start the base?
Huh?
Can I start the base?
Yeah. Now it's time to add your red sauce. Obviously before you add the sauce, add in any onions, mushrooms, sweet corn, veg, whatever you want to put.
Save most of them for the top.
Depending on how big of a lasagna you're gonna do, how many layers, if it's just for like the size that we're doing and you're not gonna do like that many layers, like one packet of mince and one sauce is enough. But like if you're doing like 4 or 5 people, good nice layers, you're gonna need 2 mince, 2 sauce.
Big tray.
Or you could use that tray, but you'd be able to have nice thicker slices of mince, whereas I do like 2 thin ones and then like a nice big one, basically.
So like 4 for the top. I just use this and then we just make another one.
No, because you have no tray. So just
Yeah, well, I could put in a little tray. I'll just do
No, it's fine. Just leave that as the bottom, then this can be the top. Well, how many are them?
There's 6.
There's 6. Take 2 out then. Or 1.
Why then? We're going to be missing some.
And then you can put a hard one in the middle.
Yeah, but I was making a dent at the outsides.
So take the stuff out and make some more dents.
Like I'm making a little tray.
No, that's long because it's small and it's not deep like that. It looks deep, but it's not. The mince is done. I'm going to leave that to the side now. I'm actually going to start prepping like the sweet corn and stuff like that I need to do. And obviously Ray's just continuing to boil sheets, and then we're gonna make it, and I'll show you how I make it, what I do with the white sauce and the cheese, blah blah.
You know, people are saying we should do skin routine, this is this routine.
Why? I got bad skin.
What's it called?
Who wants to learn from me? I got acne.
Do cake layers. And what else? Clothes layers. Yum yum.
I can't wait to eat these.
Keep forgetting that.
I'm just over here putting the garlic balls on a tray, basically.
Just keep these ones fucking soft, so. The bed is frozen.
Now just leave them on a plate, because you're going to make them soggy.
I'm not, I'm going to take them out soon again. I'm not leaving them in that long.
Oh, that's cute.
What?
Are you allowed to put them in this tray?
Yeah, you can put them in.
Oh, look, guys, that's so cute. I'm still gonna put it on my tray just in case it decides to explode everywhere. But
yeah, the
garlic. Seven to 10 minutes. We'll put those in last.
Oh, I smell the garlic.
They smell good, smell it.
Yummy. You should have got garlic bread as well though.
No, it's too much.
Okay, it should come back up now. They're more fluffy again. Before it was too hard, like, because I left it out for too long. It's easier to hold, look.
Oh, okay.
So
I was wondering why you did it
inside. Obviously, we have put less mince because we have less mince, and also we're trying to do as much layers with less mint, if you know what I mean.
As long as you've got like some in every little section, you don't actually notice there's only a little bit. Like when you had it before, did you was you like, oh, where's the mint? You know, it tastes like there's enough, so.
Oh, well, you didn't put sauce on that. Can you put sauce on?
No,
it's cheese. I thought you were going to put sauce on. Because some people put like the, what's the corn on and all that other stuff. Sticking a bit.
I'm
careful. Sounds slippery. Wait, move it over a little bit. Make sure there's some in this corner, because there was none in that corner the last time.
to heat up and everything. What are you doing? What is that?
It's a cheese sauce.
Oh. You might as well put it back over there. There's nothing I'm going to do. Wait, I need bowl.
I need bowl. need a little refreshing. I need more.
Whoa, one knee fell off. Alright. You don't have to, but I like to heat mine up and melt a little bit of cheese in it. Just because the sauce ain't like even cheesy really, it's just kind of creamy. I need that. Some people add like black pepper and stuff like that in this. You can add whatever you want. I just like a plain cheese sauce, to be honest. You can add whatever cheese you want in it. But I just like cheddar.
Oh, if you added mozzarella, it'll make it stringy.
Yeah, but I hate too much stringiness. Like, okay, once it starts to like sound like it's getting hot, just add some cheese.
Can we put this in?
Yeah, once we put this in. Like, when this is nearly done. Nearly melted, turn it off and take it up. Oh, it sounds so sticky. How do you just move this here? I think it's here. You're gonna hold it. Can you see it?
Then bring them closer.
Okay. Can you see it?
Yeah, in the way.
It's not really good anymore. Yeah.
No, I saw that big clump.
Oh, cheese.
No, I don't know what it was, but I saw a clump.
Heat up too long because legit this thing will burn quick and your I was gonna say mac and cheese, your thing is gonna taste
your lasagna
is gonna taste burnt out. Basically just make sure it goes over the sheet. These ones are sticking up so they're probably gonna burn at the top. We can just cut it off. Yeah, I know, but the ones that I like are up. It depends how the heat hits it.
We're going to put cheese.
Yes.
I put cheese on it. And this one.
Lots. Basically, yeah.
You have to do what they do with the salt or whatever it is when you go like this.
No,
it's never. I'm gonna spread it.
I was doing it. Why are you making noise?
Because I kept it on.
Why?
Because
This is when I take the cheese off you. Go away!
I'm gonna carry on! You didn't tell me how much, so that's why I wasn't putting bears. I need to throw you a blocking the whole camera.
There's so much I can do about it. It needs to go in now. This is how I know, yeah, if there's enough cheese. If you touch it and your hand don't get sauce on it, there's enough cheese. Then you put it in. Don't flatten it that much.
I don't want to stick it to the side, it's just going to be a long thing.
That's my tikka. Then you put it in the oven and you put it on 200 or 8. It's hot! You're going to end up dropping it.
It's going to give it to you. It's ain't hot. Okay guys, it's finished. Looking nice and golden brown. Now we just have to play it up. If you want to go watch how, like, see how it looks like inside and everything else, just go on Charnation and you'll see that. So, this is my love.
Bye. Make sure to like, comment,
and subscribe. But see you later, Nationers.